success. Get the punt, that's a must. I don't trust.
Oh cool, okay, oh cool. In Tokyo, I'm with my goals, my shoes.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy CM Pride. First initial C, last initial N. The word pride, because fuck it, I like it, and I'm back with another video. And today I got another story time. You know, I haven't done a story time in a while. The last time I did a story time was, I think it was April, May, June, July, August, 4 months. So the last story I had was talking about me getting drunk, and you know, that story was a little crazy to me, but on to new and better things. And once again, I'm still grateful for 1,000 subscribers. Now I'm on the road to 2K. So now we about to hop into another story time, and I'm gonna give you all the time. When I used to run track and field, I was a high jumper and a long jumper. You know, high jump, I'll jump over the bar, and long jump, jump in the sand. And this story is about when I got a concussion during a track meet. It's extremely rare, but you know, this happened to me. You know, this happened to your nigga, this happened to your boy. I was concussed, and it wasn't a good feeling, it wasn't a good experience, but we're gonna get right to the story. And as usual, make sure you like, comment. New to the channel, hit that subscribe button, smash it, you know, hit it out the park. Woo, can't whistle, fuck whatever. So, comment, turn on post notifications, we gonna get right, let's get right to the story, so let's get it. Bruh, like, I was a freshman in college. I was what, like, 18 years old, I was on the track teams. Y'all know, I used to run track and field. I was a high jumper and long jumper. I was pretty good at high jump at first in high school, you know, ranked top 10 in the state, top 50 in the country. I was like really good. So when I went to Rutgers North, I was on the high jump. I was high jumping and long jumping for them. And I did well in the winter and the spring season. But this concussion took place during the springtime. This was like the month of April. So this is just a random ass meet. Like, we just go through the motions. We're doing our workouts. We have this big meet coming up. And this meet, I think, is on a Saturday, you know. I wake up early in the morning, we go on the bus. The coach bus was really nice back then, you know. Every sports team, a coach bus is very essential. So during this ride, we are facing mad teams in our division because I was doing it in Division 3. And everybody was looking nice. Everybody was running fast time. People were running fast distance time. Niggas was jumping high, jumping far. It was competition out there. But your boy CM Pride back then was up for any competition, any tough test, and I would just go tackle it head on. So I go on to long jump. I do two events, by the way. I do long jump and high jump. I usually long jump first and high jump next. So during this particular meet, for some reason, I'm struggling. Like, I'm not jumping as far as I want to. I know I work out pretty hard. I warm up really good. I'm like sweating hot, you know, ready. And for some reason, my problem with track and like how I was, that I would get too excited and that would cause me to, you know, mess up. I was too focused, if that makes any sense. I know that sounds crazy, but if you're too focused, then like, that's not really gonna do as much. It's not gonna be well for you. So feel me, I'm getting ready to go, and the first jump I think was 19-20 feet. And my, for college standards, that's ass. For high school standards, that's decent. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna shake it off. You know, I'm with a couple friends and I'm with my whole team. And they tell me, hey, yo, bum dude, you know, just relax. Just keep jumping. You'll be fine. You'll be fine. I'm like, all right, whatever, whatever. Next jump, I hit maybe like a 21, 22. I'm like, okay, I'm starting to get it going. But mind you, these guys are just going, going, going. But for some reason, the long jump pit, people weren't really jumping the farthest jumps that they usually jump. You know, I'm facing schools. By the way, this meet was at TCNJ, you know, this took place at TCNJ, and I'm facing TCNJ, I think probably Kane, Montclair, all these Jersey schools, and I'm hanging in. I'm a freshman, mind you. Most of the people I was jumping against were either sophomores, juniors, a few seniors, and the rest are freshmen. So I just keep jumping and jumping and jumping, and find out I'm in the finals. I'm in like the top eight. I think top eight goes to the finals for long jump. I don't know, I may be wrong, but that's how I remember it. Came in, I'm about to go. And when I'm about to hit that jump, it's like my coach is yelling in my ear, like, oh, motherfucker, you better jump this. Oh, you better jump that. I'm like, I'm trying my best. Like, I'm trying my best. Whatever I give is what I give. Because at this point, I'm just exhausted. I'm extremely tired. I don't know how to control my emotions, because when I used to run track, I'd be very emotional. I'd be so hyped. I'd be so mad if I messed up. I'd be so pumped and excited and happy when I did well. So it was normal for me to have these regular emotions. So your boy makes the finals. I don't remember exactly what I jumped the first time, but I assume it was a foul, because back in long jump, I used to foul a lot. Like, long jump wasn't my specialty, but in college, for some reason, I really excelled in that jumping field. So first jump, I foul. Second jump, I think I get a 21, 22-ish. Good jump. The other guy gets somewhere in between there. And the last jump, you know, you get three jumps in each jumping, you know, category. Triple jump, three jumps, long jump, three jump, high jump, three jumps. So your third jump, you always gotta wild out. So the third jump, I do the clap. You know, I just keep clapping. You know, you clap, jumpers clap to get the crowd to clap with them, to help get them going, you know, to help get us jumpers going and shit. So I clap and clap. And at first when I used to clap, it used to be scary as fuck. But now when I clap, well, I got used to it. And during that time, I was so used to clapping that the claps would really help. They would energize me. So the claps go. I'm all like, yeah, in my head, I'm like, yeah, I'm about to hit this jump. I'm about to blow it out the park. I start going. I run a couple steps. Boom, boom, boom. I start running full speed. I'm not going to foul. I'm not worried about fouling. I'm not even looking at the board. I hit that plank. Boom. I get up so high. Like, I'm literally soaring. Like, I'm looking out the end of the pit of the sand. And then once I land...
Stupid, I'm not gonna let you get the chance.
My head hits the sand, like I just start sliding. Like, if you looked closely, it looked pretty bad. Even a far distance, it looked bad, but you didn't really hear no crack, no thud. It was just sand. But, you know, let me just roll the clip so y'all can see. Y'all can judge for yourself, you feel me? So I stayed down to what seems to be like a minute. Like, I was really laying down there for a while, to me it felt like. But honestly, I was only laying down for like a minute, maybe 5-6 seconds. But to me it felt like I was laying down for eternity. Like, I'm just down, my head on the sand. I just did not want to get up because I was so tired. I just wanted to lay there. My coach was like, "Don't." My coach was immediately, his first instinct when I land, he's like, roll over, because he was so worried about the spot and the measurement than my health at the time. I'm like, wow, like, that's kind of fucked up. But he tells me to roll over, because when you long jump, they count it for where your where the back of your body's at. They don't count it for where your the front of your feet are at. They count it where the little remains of your body's at the sand. So every inch really, really matters. Like, you cannot keep your hands behind you. You just gotta be forward. Like, just go straight forward. The jump itself wasn't really that good. I think it was probably like a 17, because I hit my head. And I get up, and at first, like, my head is ringing like crazy. Like, my head is hurting. Like, it hurts, because I just hit my head on the sand. And then I get up, and I wait for the results, and I come in second place. You know, whoop-de-doo, but my head, it hurts. So I go to high jump next. I didn't really do well in high jump because I wasn't focused, because my head was hurting. So I'm all like, you know what, let me just go to the trainer and see if I have a concussion or not, because I never had a major, never had a major injury in my life till that point, 18 years, you know, I'm 19 right now, but I never had a major injury to this point like that. So I go to the big trainer from the other school, at TCNJ, I take various tests, and at first, like, I'm going to be honest with y'all, like, those tests were kind of hard to get. They're basic tests, like, watching, tracking his finger, reading shapes, numbers, all that, and I just was out of it. And he tells my coach, you know, I think he has concussion. I'm like, of course he would say that, because I didn't want to have concussion, because Penn Relays was coming up, all these big ass meets were coming up, and I have concussion. So come to find out, if you have a major injury, you can't really do much, you can't practice, you can't go to other meets, you can't do nothing. So the end of the meet, I don't know if our team won, but we probably made it respectable. And in the meet, you know, I'm just chilling, and my head just starts booming. You know, my friends were checking up on me. Niaja, shout out to Niaja, subscribe to her channel. Niaja Marie was all like, yo, like, stop running, don't stand up too fast, you know, stay chill. My friend Jaden, subscribe to Jaden's channel too. He's like, yo, you good, bro, this and that. And I'm just like, yeah, I'm fine. Just trying to go with the flow, you know. My eyes start to get, I start to close my eyes more just to rest. Like, I just lay down. But at first, you know, when we go back on the bus after the meet, it didn't even hurt me that much. And I'm all like, you know, I'm gonna be good. But then when I'm lying down, like, during at school, while everyone's at practice, I can't go to no school events, I can't do anything. I turn on the lights, and the lights flashing just hurt my head. Like, I felt like I had a migraine, like, in between here. And it was just so surreal to me. And mind you, when I had this concussion, the rest of my family, most of my family, my mom, my dad, older brother, my couple sisters, they were in Nigeria because they had to go to a funeral because my grandma passed away about a year ago. And I'm like the only child that's in America right now. And you know, when they found out it was mayhem, they're like, oh, Jimmy, you all right? Did you see the doctor? And I tell them, yeah, I'm fine. Cause I don't want people worrying so much. Like, I don't want my loved ones or close ones worrying about me so much. So I just stuck it out. You know, practice wasn't the same. Like, when I came back after the concussion, after the relays passed, you know, I was kind of depressed. I wouldn't say depressed. I was sad that I couldn't do nothing. I couldn't jump. I couldn't do much. So my head was just like, it wasn't the same. Like, school was weird. Like, I couldn't, you know, do homework. That's how concussion is. Would I want to experience that again? Hell no. But y'all gotta watch. And any kids out there that are playing any sports, especially contact sports like football or even hockey, be careful, because concussions are not fun, you know, because that shit almost fucked me up. And like, you know, you live to fight another day, you live to do this, you live to do that, you know. Life is short. You know, my concussion could have been worse. It could have been in the hospital, could have had brain damage, but luckily it was just a little thud, you know. Fast forward, we end the season, you know, I come back, I'm able to participate in about a couple meets, and then that was the end of my track career there. But if y'all want a future story time of why I stopped running track, comment below and just, you know, let me know. But hey, y'all, man, that was my story of how I got concussed in track and field. Very bizarre, very unusual to get a concussion in a sport like that. But hey, I'm bizarre, I'm unusual, so it happens. But hey, man, you feel me? Like my shit, comment, subscribe, hit that bell, turn on those post notifications. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, because if you don't subscribe, for real, you was a lame ass. But you lame, like, you lame as hell. You lame ass nigga. But hey, man, it's your boy Sam Pride signing off. I'm out. Hope you have a good day. Stay blessed. I'm gonna be back. I post every week. Let's get it. I'm out. I know I'm different from the rest. I'm chasing the bag, got no time for retreat. You talking money, want all of it, please. I pulled up before, got me stuck in a dream. I want my family over the sea, yeah. Bitches used to laugh cause I'm a rapper.